guys, Katie here. So today is February 24th, 2018. I'm going to be doing a little chit-chat getting with me here in the beginning of this vlog. So, yeah, I'm gonna get started with my hair straightener and straightening my hair. It's just what I do. It's Saturday, and usually on the weekends I try to give my hair a break, especially since I washed it last night, but I'm noticing that it just doesn't look nice today. I slept on it wet like I always do, and sometimes I wake up and it looks great, and other times I wake up and it looks like crap. So, in order to make it nice and sleek and straight, I like to put some of the Orotherapy hair oil in my hair. This is from Fanola, before I straighten it. And then I will use a heat protectant from Chi flat iron spray is what I like to use. So if you guys have been watching my vlogs for a long time, you would know that I wear this London shirt a whole bunch. It's a super oversized shirt. You can't really tell in my videos, but like, it's a really oversized shirt that I bought from Goodwill back in early high school years. And the reason I got it was just to have a nice sleep shirt, you know? And that's really what it's turned into. I wear this a lot to bed, like very often. I think my whole family probably sees it as my like, every night pajamas, because I sometimes like won't wash the shirt for a while and it'll just be my every night nightgown shirt. It's long enough on me that I can wear it sort of as like a nightgown. But anyways, the story behind this shirt is kind of funny. So back in early high school years, I used to do Tiny Chat and I was super obsessed with British like people, mainly British guys. And that's because like I had a few guys that ended up becoming just my really great friends. Like there was this guy named Danny and we Skyped every single day. He was British, really nice dude. And then I haven't talked to him in years, but another guy was Bradley, and he still stays in touch with me and he's from England. So it's just, it was at the time, and I have a lot of, you know, I had a lot of British girls viewing me too. So I was just obsessed with London, England, anything English. I even pretended to have a British accent for some time. I was just really weird back in the day. But anyways, so I remember seeing this shirt at Goodwill and I was like, I'm gonna buy that and I'm gonna wear it to bed every night, and then someday I'm gonna study abroad in England. And lo and behold, I did study abroad in college, but it was not in England. I went to Greece, and I do not regret that because now I'm in love with a different country. But I mean, I still think that London is definitely on my bucket list. But just knowing that I have viewers from all across the world is so exciting, because most of you who have been watching me for several years, I know where you live. Like, I have a YouTube friend who lives in Canada, Rachel Pretty Polishes, and then I have, there's a girl named Katie who lives in England, and I had an Australian girl viewing me for a while who I'm still friends with on Facebook. It's just amazing to me that there are so many people, and that someone commented on my last video and they're from Iceland. Guys, like, this just means that if I ever want to travel around, I have so many people I can go visit. So then I just part my hair to the side like this, and it gives it a ton of volume, as you can see. That's like my little volume trick. Okay, so hair is done. Now I'm gonna move on to makeup. I'm going to just do my eyebrows. I use the same method for my eyebrows every single time. I just run through them with a spoolie, and then I fill them in using this Coastal Scents eyeshadow. All right, so eyebrows are done. They look actually all right today, not too bad. I'm gonna go ahead and prime my eyes using the e.l.f. eyelid primer, and I just bought this the other day because I realized I need an eyeshadow primer. I've been using that NYX eyeshadow base, and that creases throughout the day. And then I also, you know, like to use the Maybelline eraser, dark circle eraser concealer on my lids, and that isn't a real eye primer either. So it's been a long time since I've used an actual eye primer, and I used to love this e.l.f. one, so I decided to pick it up again. Now I'm going to move on to priming my face. I've been loving this Too Faced Hangover RX primer. It hasn't broken me out, and it's silicone free. So I've decided, I think I'm allergic or something. My skin just doesn't like silicone primers. It doesn't like primers in general. I feel like a lot of primers break me out, but this one is not even good for someone like me who has oily skin. But I find that it makes my skin dewy, and I'm okay with dewy. I just don't like my skin look super slick and oily by the end of the day. And so far, I think this one has been great, and it doesn't, like I said, I don't think it's been breaking me out. It just has a very hydrating feel to it. It also has coconut oil in it, so it smells really nice. Alright, so for foundation, I just pumped 2 pumps of the Maybelline 24-hour foundation. This is a new product. I have the color Classic Ivory. This stuff oxidizes pretty badly though, so I'm sort of disappointed in that factor, but the coverage is amazing. Like, it's so great. And I usually use the Revlon ColorStay, but I bought this and I realized I kind of got the wrong color. You know, it oxidizes and it ends up being kind of orange on me. But I just want to go ahead and use the whole bottle up because I do like the coverage quite a lot. Like, it just has such great coverage. Look how weird that looks in this lighting. Once I blended the foundation out, I like to use my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer as an under eye concealer. I just make a, you know, a shape like that. What is that? Triangle? Yeah. And I just put that underneath my eyes. And I just set my whole face using my L'Oreal Translucent Powder. Alright, so now I'm done, and I hope you guys all enjoyed this little segment of the vlog to get it kicked off. But I'm gonna go ahead and get dressed and try to do something the rest of the day. I might work on getting ahead on some work for my job, and at some point, I'll be going over to Levi's. So it's already noon. I'm trying to decide if I want to go to Breadco, or some of you may know it as Panera, to work on some things for work. I just feel like getting out of the house. I really want to go thrift shopping, but I have no room for any new clothes. I need to get rid of things if I'm going to go buy more clothes. And so I'd like to get as much done for my job, you know, like I call it homework sort of, get all that done so that I can just relax the rest of the weekend. So Levi just made it home and he brought a bunch of his baseball souvenirs. I don't even know.
Memorabilia,
and they're all like, how much do you think all this is worth? Together, over 1,000.
Close to 2,000,
yeah.
Probably.
He has a lot. I feel like the past 2-3 Saturdays I've been at Aldi.
Yeah.
Just with these guys. And I bought a pillow. I bought something I don't need every time I come here. And we're gonna go to Walmart after this, but I got this really comfy pillow. I'm loving it. Now we're checking out at Walmart. I didn't vlog very much in the store, but I got a lot of really unhealthy stuff. For myself.
Candy.
I got candy.
Unhealthy.
And granola bars.
And those bananas. Aren't...
Oh, you guys got healthy stuff. I was talking about me.
Oh yeah, no, you're terrible.
I am. So we're at DQ right now. I very rarely come here, but whatever Levi got, and I mean, I like what I got. We both got chicken strip baskets, but this is fantastic. It's honey, what's it called? Where did the advertising? Like it's some kind of Frank's Red Hots. Spicy honey sauce.
Honey hot glazed.
Honey hot glazed. It's great. Can you move the camera?
You should go review the film.
What? Okay.
Go review the film.
It'll take me forever to do that. This has been filming for 4 minutes.
Can you not fast forward?
I don't think I can.
We'll just go back and play it to now.
I will in the future. What'd you
You'll do it in our car, right?
I can. Why?
It's really funny.
It's so nice. I just look up stage. It's so nice.
Rachel.
It's so nice. I'm gonna vlog the bowling experience.
Make sure you get all my strikes.
I'll get all of Levi's great bowling.
I'm gonna subscribe to your channel.
Thank you, Cadence. That's so kind of you. Levi somehow managed to get himself a free pizza. I don't know how he did this.
This is what it's all about.
It looks good, honestly. But we're in the city. We're at a bar. I don't really know how he managed to do that, but he did. Alright, so Levi and I are chilling out at his place. It's February 25th now.
We're just watching Parks and Recreation. And my camera case finally came in the mail. Look, I got a camera case.
What's up? Oh, that looks so nifty.
Thanks, it's very nice. And then I also got this really cool little vintage case to put it in. So, this little vintage case.
So this is what the rubberized, I guess it's silicone case for the G7X looks like. And I haven't vlogged all day today because Levi and I decided to go out last night. I might have some clips of that, I think. My camera died last night, that's why I didn't vlog. But we ended up going out to downtown St. Louis with his friend, and we stayed down there with his friend, and it was fun. But then, of course, since I drank a little bit, I woke this morning, we came back here. I didn't sleep very well last night, so I've just been really, really lazy all day, and my camera's been dead. So finally, I was able to get my battery charged, and now we're just chilling out. I'm about to do some work. And so far, though, I really do like this rubberized case. It looks kind of cool on my camera.
So I'm at Jason's Deli, and this is the biggest baked potato I've ever seen, and I'm really excited about it. Like, here's my hand in comparison. It's huge.
It's February 27th now, and I decided I would do a small, like, day in my life sort of section of this vlog. I feel like this vlog's gonna be pretty long enough because the beginning was a get ready with me, but there hasn't been anything else really entertaining. So, anyways, the first thing I do is I get into work around 9 a.m., and my boss doesn't come in for sometimes, like, an hour. Sometimes he gets in 9:30, sometimes he gets in at 10, sometimes he gets in at 10:30, so it really just depends on the morning. But yeah, the first thing I usually do is just look at my to-do list for the day, and so that's just written down on this little pink sheet. I also have been making myself green tea. I've mentioned this, I think I mentioned this in my last vlog, but I gave up caffeine, like, pretty much completely. I did have a little bit of coffee on Sunday morning, but that was the first cup of, like, that was the first sip of coffee, caffeinated coffee, that I've had for over a month. So I did a really good job giving up caffeine. Like, I did it cold turkey, and I hated myself for it at first, but now I'm not addicted to caffeine anymore, so it's kind of nice. I don't rely on it to be awake. And so I just like to drink this decaffeinated green tea in the morning, so I'll make myself a cup of this or any kind of tea, really. And then I'll just get started on my first to-do list thing of the day. I schedule the day out by hour, so from 9 to 10 I have to work on whatever it says I have to work on from that time. So it's lunchtime at work. It's around lunchtime at work, and it's beautiful out, so I'm just walking this to the trash. It's part of my job, actually, sometimes. Woohoo! Casual. What are you doing, puppy? What are you doing? Why are you out? Come here! There's a dog, and I don't know what to do about it. Alright, goodbye. I don't even know what to do about that. There was literally a dog. And if he's not gonna come up to me, I don't know what to do. And now I changed into this beautiful top. I don't even think we have a name for this one yet, but it is just a gorgeous lace sleeveless top with a statement necklace. I don't even think we sell this necklace anymore, but it's good for the photos. And I'm keeping these wedges on because they make me feel really tall. So I oftentimes will just bring a frozen meal for lunch, and I like to eat it out here on this table. And yeah, can't wait for us to maybe get a patio set so we can start eating outside too. All right, so I'm off work now, and I just went to go attach this and put it all together again. I had made it into the short form of whatever this is called, and it was too short, and now I put the long arm on it, and now it's, so yeah, we're gonna see how this goes. So it will not stick to my actual dashboard. It has to go on the glass, which, I mean, I guess I knew that. And we are rolling. I was able to get the dashboard camera mount set up, and I think I like where it's positioned right now. We're just gonna see how distracting it is for me. I think it's the best place for it, off to the left side of my window shield, because if I put it towards the middle, it's going to distract me too much, so we'll see. All right, so I'm at Levi's now, and I am whipping up some cookie dough.
Hey, what's up?
What are you guys making?
Tacos.
Yep. How do you say taco backwards?
Okay. Oh, golly, you got me.
I'll just time lapse action.
You know what I mean? Like, just, yeah, like, I, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just gonna cook this. And so,
look at them rices! Look at them beans!
Ah.
You eating some peanuts, buddy? Oh my god, that's a lot of peanuts. All right, so I've just been watching Girl Boss on my phone as I get ready at Levi's. This is my Wednesday morning routine. Usually I get ready here by myself since he has already left, but I am about to head to work after I eat some food here. And then, I haven't mentioned it yet, but in a few days on Friday, so this weekend, I'll be going to UCM. So that's where I went to college. I'm gonna go visit Carlin, my friend Carlin and Casey there. And I haven't been since October, so I'm excited to go visit them.
Okay, so I am back home now. I've been home for a little while, and I am just currently uploading a video. Let's see. It should be done within, 9 minutes.
I'm Jordan. So I'm sitting here also, and I just realized that I never showed you guys my interview on Show Me St. Louis, so I'm going to look that up now, and I will just film the screen.
You can go to ksdk.com and, like, just search my name, and the interview should come up. Says YouTube star is the face of Chesterfield online retailer. So let's watch it.
Monday morning, I'm Honey Glouse. A boutique in Chesterfield closed its doors 3 years ago and hasn't looked back because it's now doing better than ever before. Dana Dean takes us inside Pulse Fashion, a popular online retailer with a YouTube star on its staff.
This is a really cool story, Heidi. Pulse is still in Chesterfield, but it's no longer a brick and mortar boutique. It is strictly online now, and I visited the warehouse filled with clothes that get shipped around the country. Meet the face of online retailer Pulse Fashion.
It is absolutely adorable. It combines a bunch of trends into one.
This is YouTube star Katie Leggett.
In today's video, I'll go over my hair.
She has more than 100,000 subscribers and was hired by PulseFashion.com to be a digital marketing specialist.
It's comfy and chic. And I just so happened to be kind of scrolling through job postings one day, and I thought, well, this is kind of perfect for me. I've been doing YouTube videos related to beauty and fashion for the past 9 years.
PulseFashion.com, known for trendy and affordable clothing, is based in Chesterfield and has a large social media following of its own, 140,000 Facebook fans and counting.
If
you're not online, you're not doing social media, you're not doing digital marketing, you know, you won't be around long.
Todd Winehouse is the CEO, and believe it or not, the guy who picks out all the clothes.
I am the buyer. This is the buyer. My mother blessed me with a, you know, good eye.
Todd and his mother owned a brick-and-mortar boutique in Chesterfield for 9 years called Pulse.
That was more of a higher-end boutique.
But in 2015, he realized not a lot of women were willing to pay high prices for clothes.
Not $150 pair of jeans, $200 shirt.
They closed the shop, focused on their website as well as social media, and haven't looked back.
Not even a second.
Business has never been better.
We can do in a week what we did in a month.
Pulse Fashion moved into a warehouse in Chesterfield where they pack and ship clothes around the country. It's also where Katie does all the videos for Pulse Fashion social media.
Cameras are always rolling here at Pulse Fashion.
And for Pulse Fashion, this is just the beginning.
Sky's the limit. I see it as a multi-million dollar business. We want to be a large company.
So to check them out, go to PulseFashion.com. There's also a coupon code there you can get for watching the show today. And also check them out on Facebook at Pulse Fashion. I just love seeing local businesses, local companies succeed like this.
Oh, that's an amazing story.
And how brilliant that they incorporate a YouTuber into the business plan, in really cute clothes, too.
I mean, really, win, win, win.
Yeah.
Levi never calls me.
My boyfriend never
Hello?
Yeah.
So, what is your plan for the rest of the night? Are you going to go to bed soon?
Hmm. Okay guys, so she's talking to him now, so I'm gonna go off and I'm gonna vlog a little.
That's Lulu, this is her little area. She likes to chill in here, she likes to go under there. She's a litter box. And this is like my cute area. My private room like actually matches, it's really cute. I do this also like right before I go to bed. It's doesn't have any water in it right now because I used it all when I went to bed. That's my gross dishes I need to take downstairs. Oh guys, so this is like, you know, comment down below if you think I should be in the vlogs more. And then if so, I will do a, I love this camera. Oh my god, this is so cool.
right in, okay, so you guys are sitting literally right where I filmed that 9-year-old does my makeup video, which you guys should go watch, because that was me. If you guys are new subscribers, I was like right here, and I was like, so grab a cotton ball. Oh my god, like I had like the same blemishes. Kind of, not really.
Alright, so I don't know why my camera does this, but I think the lighting in my room really makes it look super red. So hopefully if I ever paint my walls white, that'll change. But I've just been sitting here on my laptop watching videos. Sometimes I get on these like little spurts of just sitting here and binge watching videos on acne routines, like skincare routines, because I'm really trying to clear my skin up. But yeah, so sometimes I just watch a bunch of videos on YouTube about how people clear their acne up, and then I get sad because everyone's different. I don't know what's gonna work for me. I do want to try cutting out dairy. I do think that that would help, but I don't even really eat that much dairy in general. But anyways, enough babbling. I think I'm gonna actually end the vlog here because I realized that I don't really want this vlog to be super long, and I think I have enough footage now to make it into one whole vlog. So I hope you guys all enjoyed watching. I will vlog this weekend when I go to my college town to visit Casey and Carlin, and that'll be hopefully entertaining and fun. They are going to be stressed out all weekend with midterm stuff, but regardless, I'm going to try to get some fun footage there. So yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!